The immune system's first defense is our skin, the largest organ of our body. The skin covers a total area of about 2 square meters, the size of a typical basketball backboard. When microbes attack, they're routinely deflected by the skin. Inside our bodies, mucous membranes are slimy, warm surfaces that make up about 400 square meters, roughly the size of an entire basketball court. They're under constant attack from microbes in the air we breathe and the food we eat. They line our nose, throat, intestines, and reproductive tracts. That's a large area to defend. Your mucous membranes are going to need help. Fortunately, certain cells in your body have evolved to fend off microscopic attackers. Early responders, like this macrophage, identify invaders and attack. They also give off chemical signals, called cytokines, to call up reinforcements like neutrophils and natural killer cells. Macrophages, neutrophils, and natural killer cells, collectively referred to as innate immunity, are nonspecific, often sacrificing healthy tissue to contain an infection. But if the invader slips through, you're going to need a more targeted defense. The adaptive immune system provides a more targeted defense. Dendritic cells are like intelligence specialists. They collect pieces of the invader at the site of the battle. Then they travel to the nearest lymph node, triggering a cascade of events. Inside the lymph node, the dendritic cell presents pieces of the invader to T cells, the immune system's communication specialist. In turn, T cells activate B cells, training them to form antibodies, the molecular weapons that target the invader specifically. The immune system now mounts its ultimate defense. B cells release millions of antibodies, each antibody's shape tailored to identify and neutralize the enemy. The immune system deploys these tailored weapons until the infection is wiped out, ready to respond even faster the next time.